In this video, we're gonna have a look on how we can get Android 14 running on a Raspberry Pi 5, of course, with an IPS screen. In order to get started, we're gonna need to download some files from costakang.com, link in the description. Go to Devices, Raspberry Pi 5, Costakang Lineage OS 21, scroll a little bit down, full image, select free access and start download. In order to save some time, I have already downloaded the file and put it in a separate folder. You'll get something like this. It's a zip image that you will need to extract. And once done, start the Raspberry Pi imager, choose device, in our case Raspberry Pi 5, OS, this will be custom. Select the image file that we have just extracted, open, storage, this is the SD card that I have connected to my computer. Next, I do not want to apply customization, yes, I want to erase. We're gonna use some internet magic and speed this up. Once completed, you can click on continue, remove the SD card and move it to your Raspberry Pi. So let's see if it starts, shall we? And welcome to Lineage OS. This is the initial setup wizard. Just next, user license agreement, language English. This is where we select our Wi-Fi, confirm. Next, select your proper time zone. Next, locations enabled, OS features, accept. I don't want to put a code right now, don't have nothing to restore. Free button mode, and finish. We have successfully installed Android on the Raspberry Pi 5. If we scroll up, and go to settings, I'm done. In storage, you can see that the standard image only shows us 8 GB. In order to benefit for the full storage of the microSD, we need to do a few small changes. I hope you can see on the screen being filmed like that. So let's go back, open a web browser. We will need to go to costakang.com again. Device, Raspberry Pi 5, close the commercial. Here we have Lineage OS, the same that we downloaded earlier. And in frequently asked questions, which is a little bit lower, you'll find this entry about resizing your SD card. Just click on the resize link, select the mirror, primary in my case, and allow download. If we go back to the desktop, go to settings, here on search just type advanced, you'll find advanced restart if you scroll down here, and enabled. This will allow us to enter the recovery console that is needed to write that zip file that we have just downloaded. Now if you pull the top menu, go to power, restart, we have the option to restart to recovery. Select install, go to downloads, Lineage Raspberry Pi resize, click on it, swipe to install, wipe Dalvik, swipe to confirm, and reboot system. We now have a fully functional Android Pi. And if we go to settings, storage, you can see that we have the full space available, 12 GB used out of 128. If we go back home, we can open a web page. We can access our Home Assistant dashboard. a fully functional dashboard. Probably we need another dashboard that will fit better on the screen. Or why not watch your favorite video on YouTube? That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.